Space, the final frontier. My name is Captain Foley, and these are my adventures. Captain's Log, Stardate 69902.54, or 20151125. Welcome back, everybody. It is time for Captain Foley's Captain's Log, and it's almost Christmas time, so I've got a Christmas tree set up. It's a Trekyards tree, so we're going to check it out. I'm going to show you the ornaments, and then I'm going to get to all your questions and comments and a few things that I'd like to talk about. So let's start our Captain's Log by panning down over this tree. We got Trip there in his Enterprise uniform. Got a little TOS Delta that a friend of mine made for me. Klingon bird of prey. Get around to the back so you can see the engine detail. Hopefully you saw that. Enterprise E. Over here we have the Enterprise D. This one doesn't light up. This one actually has a base. It's the 25th anniversary of TNG. It's got a base that plugs into, and the base makes the sound and lights. Same with this one. This one's beautiful. But it doesn't light up unless it's on the base. And it's got the classic TOS music. Definitely one of my favorites. Here's the Enterprise D. It does light up. Very cool ornaments, these Hallmark ornaments. Here's the Reliant, which does light up. And we're going to move over. We got R2-D2 there. He does make sounds, but ever since I've replaced the batteries, he doesn't work for some reason. And yes, the batteries are incorrectly. We've got the NX-01, the pewter one from Hallmark, which is very heavy. That's why it's kind of nestled in there. But it also has a hanging display base that has the sound on that. Got a little mini R2-D2 and C-3PO. And the USS Defiant. The reason I'm showing this off is it's going to be in the background during my captain's log, and I don't know how much detail you're going to see on it, so Captain Benjamin Sisko. And if you turn him around, he's holding his baseball behind his back. And we have the transporter room. Of course, this has lights and sound as well. Looks so different on the screen than it does in real life. In real life, it's just a quick flickering. On here, it's very fluid almost. Very interesting. Now scroll down here, we've got our Kitinga. Kitinga, of course, lights up and shoots. Got our con.
They still haven't raised their shields. Raise ours. Their shields are going up. Lock faces and ties. They're locking faces. Raise shields. Fire! You still remember. I cannot help but be touched. I, of course, remember you.
And another one.
Admiral, it's coming through now, Tom. Time's up, Admiral.
This is cool.
Here it comes. Fire.
So yeah, that's my Star Trek II ornament. Move up a little bit. This is the first Hallmark ornament I ever got.
Shuttlecraft to Enterprise. Shuttlecraft to Enterprise. Spock here. Happy holidays. Live long and prosper.
And there's this year's. It's the Enterprise C, Ambassador class. It lights up nice and bright. We've got Voyager here. Of course, lit up. And lastly, over here, we have the Enterprise refit, which also lights up. There we go. So that is the Trekyards Christmas Tree. Hope you guys enjoyed that little look at my Hallmark ornaments and this very, very unique little tree. And now we're going to move on to the full captain's logs. I got a lot of questions and comments from you guys, and I do have quite a few things to talk about, so this should be quite a action-packed episode, if you will. So let's get right to it, okay? So we have 21 comments on today's Captain's Log, and we're going to get to all of them. So it might be a little bit longer log, plus I got quite a few things I'd like to talk about. But why am I wearing cool shredder shades, you're asking? Well, B Pisano 1 actually double dog dared me to do it because he saw my Loot Crate unboxing with these, and so he said to wear these in the captain's log. So I'm doing that because I like them. I think they're cool. What do you think? If you're a Transformers fan, you can even paint them yellow, and you got like the little bumblebee horns too. You have to get rid of this little part at the top here, but I think they're kind of cool. I don't think I'd wear them in public, and they're kind of small for my face, but I think they're kind of cool. So there you have it. So what we're going to do is we're going to read all these 21 comments and questions from people like you, or maybe even specifically from you. And then we are going to get into a few things that I want to talk about. And we're going to close it out by, I'm going to turn off the lights in the room, and you're going to get to see this lovely Christmas tree in all its Star Trek blue, red, and white light glory. And until then, you know, during the course of this Captain's Log, you can definitely look at it and enjoy it and take it all in. And hopefully you guys really appreciate it that I put together this little Trekyards tree for you guys, because it's taken up my model desk and I can't make any models. Not that I've been doing that lately anyway, but now that I find that I can't do it, I want to do it. So it's going to be here till Christmas time for sure. So anyway, we're going to talk about all that in just a little bit. Let's get to all the questions and comments. Okay, I'm not going to wear these damn sunglasses for the whole thing, because really that was not part of the double dog dare. You just said to wear them in the captain's log, which I'm doing. So I think I'm going to take them off now, because I'd like to be able to see what the hell I'm doing. One of the coolest things that was in this loot crate this month, if you haven't seen that unboxing, check it out. It's very popular on the tube right now. It kind of blew up, as it were, and became almost viral. I'll get into that a little bit later. Let's get underway with the questions and comments and things. And I know this isn't the normal view you guys are used to, but I wanted to include my tree. I still got the L cars up there for you guys to love and appreciate, because I know you love the L cars, and because you just a little bit more of a different view of what's going on around here. So in Trekyards Command. All right, first is from Jack Peacock. Big fan of all of yours and Samuel's videos, Captain. I have watched all of your Trekyards unloads. I think you mean uploads. And your first Fleet Yards upload. Was wondering if you had any material regarding Fleet Yards, as I'm a huge Stargate fanboy and would love to see your take on some of the ships we see in Stargate. Great work so far. Well, I'm going to let you know that Samuel is also a huge Stargate fan. I am not really, but that's a different story. But anyway, maybe episode 2 of Fleet Yards, when it gets done, will be about a Stargate ship. Who knows? Go on to power 543. Samuel. This is Commander Cockings again, so yeah. So let's see what the commander has to say. If you had to go down with your ship or to save your ship, how would you want to go? Almost saving a Klingon colony like the Enterprise C, falling down a mountain like Captain Kirk. Winky face, seriously, Samuel? Seriously? This can either be yourself in a situation or via your orders on your starship. Ideally, I don't want to go down with my ship, Samuel. I'd like to live to a ripe old age and retire and, maybe become an admiral and then, save Earth and get demoted because I stole a starship and I broke a lot of rules. But if I had to go down with my ship or die on an away mission, I, of course, would want to go out heroically. Maybe even one of my tactics that we use a lot when we're talking about verses on Trekyards, warping my ship into another ship. I don't think I'd take my whole crew with me. I'd try to get them off the ship first. So you guys are all safe. Don't worry. I'm not going to take you out with me. But I think in a no-win situation, the best way to win is by having the other guy not make it. So if the odds are against me, pull a Captain Picard from Star Trek Nemesis, ram my ship into another ship, although not at such a slow speed. I'd try to go for warp. If I couldn't go for warp, then I would definitely go at the slow speed. As for just me on a planet kind of thing, it would have to be in a phaser fight. Shoot them out. Kind of old school Wild West type of deal where it's me and another guy and I'm going to try to take him out. So, does that answer your question, Samuel? Carmelo Ailman, Mellotron. Just wondering if you guys had any plans on doing a series discussing the individual races in the Star Trek universe, like y'all do in Trekyards. Also, I'm sorry to hear you're having a hard time with Sins of the Solar Empire Armada 3 mod. I've never had a problem with it. It's a great game when it's working perfectly. Like I said in my last one, it does crash for me most of the time. But I can't get used to the interface, so I haven't played it a lot. That being said, I need to play it more. So, not a series particularly talking about alien races, but maybe that can be part of a Treknology episode or a fact file. Maybe it might do an extended fact file or something where it's just talking about a particular race, their history, their involvement with the Federation, or their aggression towards the Federation, something like that. Just doing a history of the race, talking about their culture, things like that. I think that's definitely a possibility, and it's something that we have considered. We kind of did one with our 1 year anniversary special with the Tholians, because we kind of talk a lot about the Tholians. If you haven't checked it out, check it out. It's just a regular Trekyards episode, but it's our 1 year anniversary one, so we made it a little bit special and kind of focused not just on the ships, but on the race that are the Tholians. So that could be something that we could consider doing in the future, absolutely. The next comment is from Dontals 1992. I just must post comment before video end. I did not watch the video about the Maquis ship. Must see it after this one. I know it is hard work making these videos and to find the time. Just want to say good job and thank you. Well, thank you very much for that. Thank you. Much, much appreciated. Enterprise H goes on to say, I'd be very interested in hearing the specifications of the hero ship and your fan series idea. Well, yes, we do have this fan series idea. We talked about this months ago. I haven't mentioned much about it, and there's a reason for that. The project's kind of on hold right now. We're working a few things out, and plus we've been busy with other things. So don't worry. The ship that we have for that series will be discussed at some point. Don't worry. We just need to figure out when everything is happening and how it's happening, and we will definitely keep you informed. You'll be one of the first to know, you guys out there that watch the Captain's Logs. Okay. B. Bizzano, one. I should wear these for his comment. Great Captain's Log. I have a quick question for you. I'm a model builder also. And I would really like a kitbash kit bash a TOS era destroyer class ship. It would be great if you could pick your brain for some tips. If I could pick your brain for some tips. However, I totally understand that your time is severely limited. If possible, what would be the best way to contact you? Also, if you do get a fan-based series going, I would love to participate in any way possible. Keep up the great work. Well, Bibizano, I would love to talk models with you. I did kit bash this one up here. The USS Holmes there. Not very good at kit bashing. It's kind of a new thing for me. So, yeah. But definitely the best way to get in touch with me would be Facebook Messenger. Get this thing sorted out here. So yeah, Facebook message me and we will definitely start talking and I will help you out any way that I can. Give you any suggestions or tips or ideas or whatever you need from me. I can definitely do that. But yeah, definitely Facebook Messenger is the best way to get a hold of me. Or contact us at Trekyards. Just go to trekyards@hotmail.com and do it that way. As for helping us with a fan-based series, that would be incredible. We've got a lot of offers for help for doing research and finding pictures and things like that, which at some point we might take you up on because really this is quite an endeavor that we do and it's sometimes hard to get everything done. So thank you for the suggestions and comments and offers, and we will definitely consider them, but I'll let you guys know. All right, so I can take these off now, right? I think that satisfied your double dog dare rules, guidelines, I don't know. Sorry if I'm a little bit this morning, but I haven't had my full coffee. Tim Hortons. Distinctly Canadian. Best coffee in the world. All right. Andrew Hopkins, what knights do you typically stalk? Jedi or medieval? Oh, referring to my Knight Stalker 666 gamer tag. It's funny because that's exactly why it was created, because I had written a fan or a vampire novel when I was late teens. And this vampire was a knight, and he eventually became a Knight Stalker, and it was a play on words because he was a vampire, so it was at night, but he used to be a knight, and he would hunt, like, knights in armies as part of his feeding frenzy, so I guess medieval knights, but yeah, I'd definitely go for Jedi knights, things like that. But good question, interesting question. If you don't know what I'm talking about, Knight Stalker 666, it's my gamer tag for everything I play, pretty much since I was a teenager, so, and it was just in reference to my handle for Star Trek Online, which you guys should be a part of the fleet by now. Thank you, Andrew. Brandon Lissick, hey, Trekyards, if you could, Trekyards, two words, Trekyards, only one word, I get that on all my comments, I see Trekyards as two words, not all of them, 90% of them, but just so you guys know, it's one word, Trekyards is one word, but anyway. Hey, Trekyards, if you could have any warp core power source under the hood of your car, which one would it be? Probably quantum singularity drive, like the Romulans have. Just because it'd be wicked cool to get in a car accident and just be sucked into a black hole. Your car, you, the car you hit. I think it'd be interesting. I really don't know. That's kind of a weird question. Mad Shimon, what tier is your fleet? I'm on the looks for tier 5 with my Federation character. We wish. We're on tier 1 still for everything. Yeah, we're not up there yet. We want to get there, and we need help from people like you to do that. So, join the fleet anyway. We're not tier 5. Skyla Jade Foster, or Sky. I have all 4 of my Federation characters in the fleet now. Awesome. I'm really excited to help with the Starbase, and I've already contributed to it yesterday. Well, technically one is a Romulan, but oh well. No problem. Yeah, I haven't seen many of you guys in-game. I've seen a few of you, and I've even invited 1 or 2 of you to my bridge to hang out and check out my TOS Connie ship. So, if you see me in game, give me a holler, and I will definitely love to hang out with you and chat with you in game. And I look forward to meeting all of you there at the Fleet Starbase. We have a Fleet Starbase event coming up soon, which I'll talk about before it happens. I'm actually having a Skype call with Samuel and Timothy Champion later today in regards to what's going on with that. So it'll kind of be a meet and greet video where we hang out in game and chat, and then you guys can either participate in it, because I'll probably have the date and time and stuff when, like, before, I'll have it announced before it actually happens so that you guys can possibly join in. So keep that in mind. Empyrean Frost, apologies for not really commenting, sir. Been sick. It's all right. You don't have to comment on every captain's log. I appreciate it, but I hope you're feeling better. At any rate, what is your favorite perimeter defense ship in Starfleet? The ships, Starfleet tasked to the outer edge of the Federation. I would have to say the USS Grau, the Trekyards original ship that we did last Saturday. If you haven't checked it out, watch it. USS Grau, G-R-A-U. It's a fan-made ship by Mario Marino, and it's awesome. And it is just that. It's for the outer edge of the Federation perimeter, exploring, doing things like that. So that's what I have to say it is. Other than that, I don't know specifically which ones are Border Patrol ships, so I can't really answer that question. You got to realize, when I read these comments, generally they're the first time I've read them. I don't pre-read them because I want to kind of be surprised and, you know, like you guys, hear them for the first time. If you guys want me to change that, if you'd rather I read them through and have things really structured and prepared, that's fine. I know at least one of you out there, my brother Steve, is yelling, yes, that would be excellent. Please do that, you dumbass. But I don't know. I just, it comes in my head, I need to make a captain's log tomorrow, or I need to make a captain's log today. I got time. I'm free. I'm going to just go do it, set up the camera, boom, get it done, because I always have stuff, other stuff I have to do. And so it's usually an off-the-cuff kind of thing. So what do you guys think? Let me know. So the next question is from T-Money HD. Stuart, what is your favorite series out of TNG, Voyager, DS9, or TNG? I think you mean TOS somewhere in there. TOS would have to be my favorite just because it's the first one. You know, I'm a TOS kind of guy. Out of the other ones, though, I have to say DS9 is probably my favorite. It was my least favorite for a long time. I didn't watch it for years and years and years. Couldn't get into it. Always saw the stupidest episodes. Then my darling wife, Sylvia, she said I got to watch it, because it's one of her favorite series. Watched it, and it's definitely one of my favorite series now. I would say it's TOS, then DS9, then TNG, then Voyager. Enterprise and Voyager, kind of tied. They're not bad, don't get me wrong. We have a station here in Canada called Space. And every day at 4 o'clock, they play TNG. Every day at 5 o'clock, they play Voyager. They've completed the Voyager series to the end, beginning to end, at least 4 times. And then I'm always hoping that as soon as they get to the last episode, they're going to start a new series. Like Enterprise, DS9, I don't care. Just something not Voyager. And all the time they restart Voyager. So it's always TNG and Voyager that's on there, and it's annoying. Years ago they used to have TOS, TNG, Deep Space Nine, and Voyager all playing in a row, which was awesome. It was like a Star Trek afternoon, but people complain because not everybody's Star Trek fans. They want to see other things. Who cares? You watch your stuff later at night when it's on. The afternoon is for Star Trek fans. really, seriously. They need a Star Trek channel. They have enough Star Trek shows, enough hours of Star Trek content, movies, animated series, specials, everything. They could have a Star Trek channel, and I really want them to do that. That's what I kind of want this all-access CBS thing to eventually be about. Just a thought. So, out of the ones you asked, TNG, Voyager, DS9, or TNG, I'd have to say DS9 would be my favorite. Tied very closely with TNG, and then Voyager and Enterprise will have to be kind of lumped together too. Cyber Shaman X, hey Cap, or anybody for that matter, there's a little program for the Sins of the Solar Empire Star Trek 3 mod called the Large Address Aware Tool. supposed to help the game be able to use more than 2 gigs of RAM and prevent it from crashing. I had the same issue. You can always use it for other games too. See if that helps your crashes. You can download it here, and he provided a link. That's awesome. I'll include this link in the description below for anybody that else that's having problems with their Sins of the Solar Empire Armada 3 mod crashing on them. Thank you very much, Cyber Shaman. Michael Payton. Are you planning on entering the Star Trek Star Wars crossover ship model contest in the Star Trek Modelers group? With all the different ships you have seen, critiqued, and studied, I would be interested in seeing what you come up with. No, I know I haven't considered it, Michael. Unfortunately, I just don't have time to build a model or design anything. I mean, I got to finish this Constitution refit 350 scale that you see on my bench here. It has been for quite a while on my bench. Where did this come from? Anyway, yeah, I got too much on my plate. I can't do that right now. I would love to take a look at the entries, though. And we judged the Star Trek one, Samuel and myself, as well as Doug Drexler, Rick Sternbach, John Eves, Andrew Probert. But it was fun judging that with all those guys. There is an episode coming up with Bill Cross's winning entry, the USS Shangri-La, on Trekyards. We have to talk to Bill yet. We got to do a few things. It'll be in the new year for sure. But it's definitely his since he won, that was part of the winning prize, was to get a Trekyards episode done on your ship. So, and I met Bill at Wonderfest. He's a wonderful guy. So look forward to that. It's going to be a great show because it's a great ship. But yes, Michael, I would love to take a look at the entries. And if you're doing any kind of contest, I would definitely love to help maybe judge. So drop me a line. Okay, only 3 more guys. JMT, car window stickers might be an idea for Trekyards merchandise. Any advice for people with MacBook Pro to run Star Trek Online? I can't get it to run properly for love or money, and it's driving me nuts. Enjoy the show. Great work. I don't have a Mac, so I can't help you with that. Anybody that has a Mac, please enter a suggestion or a comment to help her play Star Trek Online, or help them play Star Trek Online. Would be great. I don't know why I said her. I apologize. JMT. Captain Lokiowa. You're getting closer on how to say my name. Lo-ki-a-wa. Lokiowa. Yeah, I saw the Polaris video before the captain's log, and man, I wish I could be playing Star Trek Online to join your fleet. I've been wanting to play it since its release and create my own ship, but when I heard you can't actually build your own ship, I was depressed. Yes, you should be able to. Absolutely, I agree. But I would love to play the game, but since I can't, I have to live vicariously through the Star Trek Online YouTube player, Brent Justice. Also, continuing the NASA subject or topic, with all these new technologies scientists have been creating, we as humans should already be back on the moon. We should have colonies on the moon, or not colonies, at least a base of some kind on the moon, for sure. But somehow, some dummy lost the plans for the Mercury or the Saturn V rockets. Honestly, I think it is Section 31 cover-up. Gary 7 is interfering with human history, so that we're not supposed to be on the moon for some reason, so Gary 7 took care of that. That's why. I always dreamed that we could, that if we do create something like the NX Enterprise, since that's more likely than later iterations, I always dreamed to sit on its captain's chair, and say, let's see what's out there. That-a-way. Ask Kirk in the motion picture, he says. Yeah. Would be cool to be able to build your own ship in Star Trek Online. Just even if it's a mix and match kind of toolbox thing where you got different ship components, you can rescale them and whatever. That would be really neat. And I don't know why they haven't done that, to be honest. Star Trek Online, guys, get on it. The Trekyards family wants it. And we know where you live. No, we don't. Maddie Panda. Good day, Captain. It was awesome to talk for a few minutes in-game. Alex Sola in-game. LOL. Don't ask about my YouTube name. My question for the Captain's Log is, out of all the Star Trek memorabilia, which is your favorite and which is your most prized? Also, for top tens or fives, breaks the fourth wall a bit, but hey, LOL. Top 10 secondary characters. Keep up the great work, LLAP. Live long and prosper. All right, so top 10 secondary characters, definitely something we will do for top 10. So stay tuned for that. There's always great top 10s coming. As for my favorite memorabilia, I don't know. I got my picture with William Shatner, which is pretty cool. I've got a limited edition IDW collected comic from Fan Expo, which is signed by William Shatner. It's a limited number comic, and it's also signed by William Shatner, so it's even more limited. That would be another one. My 350 scale Enterprise model that I built myself, and it's lit, is definitely one of my favorite things. I really don't know. That's a tough question. I can't, don't know if I can answer it. There's also, of course, the TOS One Company Phaser remote. I don't know. I can't answer that question. It's a loaded question. It's not a fair question. Don't ask me those questions. And that is it for comments and questions from you wonderful people. So glad you enjoyed that. Hope you enjoyed that is what I should say. Don't know if you did, so I can't say glad you enjoyed that, but hope you enjoyed that. Now, there's a few things that I would like to talk to you guys about. Let's see here. So, Team Trekyards, Star Trek Online headquarters. I want you guys on the Facebook group that we created called Team Trekyards, Star Trek Online headquarters. Join it if you're not already a member. And if you want to become a member of the fleet, you need to be in this group, basically. So if you're not a member of the fleet and you want join the group. And if you are a member of the fleet and you haven't already, join the group. And I want you guys on there to share your screenshots from in-game. And it's basically designed, this group, to organize in-game activities or missions. So any in-game hangouts, if we just want to get together and share ships or uniforms or just chat and hang out in-game, I think that's something that we'll definitely do. Like I said, we're having a Skype call about that later today to talk about the initial idea that Samuel and myself and Timothy are going to create a video welcoming everybody to the fleet and kind of teaching everybody about it. So that'll be done later today, the Skype call anyway. The video should be up in the next 2-3 weeks. So stay tuned for that, and hopefully you guys can join. Also in regards to Star Trek Online, sometime in probably December or January, Samuel and myself are going to do a Star Trek Online week, where every day it's going to be a mission-style briefing show about a Star Trek Online ship. We already have our lineup picked out, so don't make any requests, because we already have the ships from Star Trek Online that we want to talk about picked out. So that's something to look forward to as well. Don't know if that's going to be in December or January. It depends on our schedules and when we can get to filming it, things like that. Now, something Samuel mentioned to me, which I think would be really fun, would be to do a question and answer type video for both Samuel and myself, where we, over Skype, I talk to Samuel and we answer your questions, both of us together, and we have a video with both of us answering your questions. It wouldn't be a very regular thing. It'd be maybe 4 or 5 times a year kind of thing. I think that might be a great idea. I just don't know where you guys could leave your questions for that specifically. Because I want to do my captain's logs like one a week or whatever, whenever I feel like doing them. Because they're very therapeutic for me to do these captain's logs. And I love your questions to me directly. So, but if you want to talk to both Samuel and myself, let me know in the comments of this video if you think that's a good idea and how we should go about creating a question list for you guys to add to, so that when we decide to do it, we have a bunch of questions at our disposal that we can answer. Because I think it'd be awesome to hear both the commanders and myself perspective on a lot of things and kind of go back and forth that way with that. So in the last captain's log, I mentioned a contest that I might be doing to give away my Captain Picard figure, the movie edition inbox. Some kind of contest, some kind of giveaway. I don't know if I'm going to do it yet, because A, I have to pay shipping, and B, I haven't really got any good suggestions for contest ideas from you guys. So I'm looking for help for you guys for that. One thing I did consider doing is over there on my regular Captain's Log background, I've actually changed a few things on the shelf. I've moved a few things and added one or two things, taken a few things away, kind of changed it up a little bit. So what the contest might be, and I want your thoughts on this, is whoever can tell me, A, how many things have changed, and B, be as descriptive as you can as to what they are, will be the winner of the contest. I'd probably get a few of the same answers, obviously, but I would choose the best ones, and if there was a few of those, I would definitely randomly pick somebody to win. So what are you guys' thoughts on that? Do you think that's a good contest idea? Do you have any other contest ideas? Let me know. I don't even know if I'm going to end up giving that away or not. I don't know yet. It's still up in the air as to what's going on with that. But I thought it'd be fun, something to do, something for you guys to interact with and actually get something from the captain. So please give me your thoughts on that and any suggestions you might have. Now, in our comments and in private messages and emails and things like that, we get a lot of requests. Please do this ship next. Please do this ship. We understand that. We want that kind of feedback because we want to know what ships you guys want to see. But when you say, please do this ship next, that's almost impossible because we have months worth of content already created and ready to go. So we can't really just, we're going to do this. We can do that sometimes if it's a special event or some kind of special request. We can maybe jockey it in somewhere, assuming it gets filmed and edited on time. But it is a process. It does take a while. And like I said, we've got stuff lined up for down the road for a month or two, usually. So just to say we'll do this next, it's not only are there things filmed and edited ready to go, but there's things that are filmed and unedited not ready to go. And then there's also the list of things we still want to do, which is already made. So we've already got a few months worth of contents ready to go, at least planned. So to just say, I want this ship next. Okay, we understand, but we can't really do that. To say I want this ship eventually, that's awesome. Just been seeing a lot of demanding comments lately, and we can't really accommodate those. We don't want to seem like assholes. We're just doing the best we can. Next thing is the Christmas tree. I really thought this was a great idea. My wife thought it would be a great idea. She went out and got me the tree. I think it's amazing. I hope you guys really enjoy it. I do. I love having this special dedicated tree for all my Hallmark Christmas ornaments for Star Trek. I've had these ornaments for years, many of them since like 1996, 97. Some of them are dated with the year on it. And they've always just been on my Star Trek shelves. I did years ago when I was first married, had two separate trees in two different parts of the house, both full-size trees. But for the past, decade or so, I haven't had the two trees. So this is nice. And it's a short little tree. It sits on the table. I got some collectibles and stuff under it to make it look like Christmas. Got my friend's gifts here for my friends from the model club. This is Blappy. This is your gift. And Keith, your gift's over here behind Gizmo. And Michael and Jim, you both have gifts too. They're just not wrapped yet. So there you go. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope it's kind of festive for you guys. It'll be the next few Captain's Logs, probably. I don't know if I'll move it. I might move it over there, and I don't know. We'll see. But hope you guys enjoyed it. I really love setting it up. I think it's great. I love this thing. This is my favorite one. Too bad it doesn't light up. The first Enterprise I came out with was a TOS one, but it was kind of misproportioned because it had lights and stuff in it. This one's perfectly proportioned. It's beautiful, and it sits on a stand with music, and it lights up. The bottom planetary dome lights up yellow, and the Bizarre Collectors light up red. I've highlighted it in one of my older videos talking about my Hallmark ornaments. You can see it light up on the sand, and it plays the music as well. It's awesome. So hope you guys have enjoyed that. Now, I've got to talk about my Loot Crate video, because I mentioned it earlier. I might as well put these on for this, too. So, I've been doing Loot Crate and Nerd Block unboxings for almost 2 years now. Loot Crate's kind of hit and miss. This month the theme was combat. I opened it up. It was awful. Nothing I was interested in, whatever. You know, I'm not interested in certain franchises. I made a video that kind of reflected that, like, oh, I didn't like this, didn't like this, didn't like this. It blew up. Last time I checked, it had like 6,700 views, which is unheard of. I didn't even, when I made it, I knew it was not one of my best episodes. So I deliberately did not put it on Facebook, or my home feed, just my personal one. I didn't put it on any the Loot Crate page or anything like that. I just made it and put it on YouTube. All my other ones, NerdBlock, Loot Crate, I make them, I advertise them, I put them on Facebook, I put them in my regular feed, I put them on their respective page feed. You know, I share them, and they get maybe 400 views, maybe. This one blew up. It's, like I said, it's almost at 7,000 views. It has 158 dislikes, and like something like 60 likes. People are all over the place, like calling me, saying, you're an asshole, or you don't know what you're talking about, or whatever, just because I don't like the things that are in the box. That's what an unboxing is supposed to be, an honest opinion. I've had a few comments say, I really appreciate your honest opinion. I'm going to watch more of your videos now because you actually say what you think instead of what everyone wants to hear. Because a lot of people open their Loot Crate or whatever, even if it's bad, and it's, they act like they won the lottery. Anyway, if you haven't checked it out, check it out. I don't know if I'll put a description. Maybe I'll put a link in the description below. I don't know. I'll probably forget half this stuff that I'm supposed to do anyway when I make this video or when I edit it together. But you got to check it out. My NerdBlock and Loot Crate unboxings. I was really disappointed with Loot Crate this month. Next month is supposed to be good. It's got Star Wars stuff in it. NerdBlock really pissed me off last month. That's another one you should watch. I switched to Sci-Fi Block instead of NerdBlock Classic, and they sent me two NerdBlock Classics instead. And I was really pissed off about that. I didn't get my Sci-Fi Block, but now I'm subscribed to just Sci-Fi Block. I don't know. It's confusing, and it pissed me off. Watch the videos. You'll understand. You'll see an upset, frustrated Captain Foley. But luckily, I have a good friend, Keith, whose present is over here. He purchased the extra NerdBlock from me for $30. So he just bought the whole thing for his own personal use or to give to family and friends for Christmas, whatever. So thank you, Keith, for that. But yeah, check it out. My latest Loot Crate unboxing is ridiculously insane. I'm not overly happy in it because I had a bad day that day and I wasn't impressed with anything that was in it. And people are all over me about it. Like, oh, it's a good video. It's just, you know, the negative, your negative vibe and demeanor, basically. That's why I disliked it. So anybody that disliked my last Loot Crate unboxing, go fuck yourself. That's all I can say. Also, with negative comments on anything of mine, whether it be Trekyards, Loot Crate unboxings, NerdBlock unboxings, anything on Facebook, I don't mind negative comments, like, yeah, I didn't enjoy this, or you should have done this better, blah, blah, blah. But when it comes to name-calling, calling me an asshole, insulting me, anything like that, there's no second chances from Captain Foley. You get banned from the channel, or you get blocked. If I block you on YouTube, you can still see my videos, but you can't comment on them, but you can still dislike them. So there's a lot of videos where I have one dislike. I think it's because I blocked somebody a long time ago and it pissed them off. So they're just one dislike on a lot of my videos. Whatever. I don't stand for that. There's no need for that. There's no need for name calling in a comment. And if I feel either attacked personally, insulted, or threatened, I will block you and ban you. No questions asked. So be nice. Even if you have something negative to say, there's constructive ways to say negative things. So please do so. Don't be an asshole. I don't need assholes in my life. I suffer from depression as it is. So regular day-to-day activities make me not want to live life. So why would I want this negativity in my life? Keep that in mind, guys. probably one of the only times I'm going to say that's exactly what I do. I've been doing that forever. So, I mean, if you push me the wrong way, you're done. I don't care. Done. And that's it. You got to check out my Loot Crate video. I can't believe it went so insanely viral. It's not viral. It's not millions of views. But compared to every one of my other unboxings, it's viral. Trust me. And it's my most hated video. And it's not even really bad. I'm not insulting in it or anything. I'm just, this isn't great. I don't like this. I'm not a fan of this franchise. So don't really care. That's basically what the video is. And it's been explained to me that it's my negative attitude that is the reason for all the dislikes. So anyway, guys, I think that's it for this Captain's Log. Thank you for tuning in and watching and loving me and loving Trekyards and coming back for more. I hope to do another one probably next week, and hopefully I'll have some ideas for this contest idea to get this gift out. I don't know. I don't even know if I'm going to do it. If there's not enough interest in it, not enough buzz is generated, I'm just going to not even bother. So, but like I said, there are things changed on the shelf over there. So it's an idea anyway. I don't know if it'll be a thing, but okay. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, ideas, insults, please put them in the comments below and I will get to them on my next Captain's Log. And yeah. Hope to see you guys very soon. It's been a busy week. Today's my only slack day. So, on my slack days, I still create work for myself by doing things like this. So, yeah. Anyway, I will talk to you all very soon. Please live long and prosper. And be kind to one another. Even on social media. No need to be insulting or be an asshole. Just because you're anonymous. So, that's my message for the day. See you guys later. Captain Foley out. Bye-bye. And just to close us out, as I said, I wanted to show you guys the tree with the lights off. Well, the main lights off and all the ornaments on. Let's all sing a song. Oh, Christmas tree, Captain Foley should never sing. He is so bad at singing. Holy crap, why is he singing? Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Trekyards tree, your glory is something or other. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I will see you in the next Captain's Log or the next Trekyards. Boldly go.